Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. Anticipation is mounting for today's game, and we've got two quarterbacks looking to make an impact. It's the Bills going up against the Jets. So for the call of this week's 17 matchup, let's send it out to our broadcast team, Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
All right, Larry, EA Sports coverage of the NFL finds us at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. Today, the curtain falls on the regular season, and we've got a good one in store between the Buffalo Bills and the New York Jets. Hi again, everyone. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you look at this Jets ball club. They come in losers of two straight, so they're trying to right the ship here a little bit.
They're teetering a little bit, aren't they? And now things could really go south if they lose this game, so they understand the importance of playing well and stopping this streak.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Bills, they come in just in an absolute free fall, losers of seven in a row.
And this is where you turn to your best players and look at them and say, can you guide us out of this? We've got to be better than what we've shown.
Two teams here playing for pride as the final week of the NFL season is underway. This one taken from the seven. Oh, look at that.
Oh, look at him turn.
And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. So now here comes the Jet offense as they get ready to take over. Leading them out is going to be their quarterback. That's the grizzled vet, Ryan Fitzpatrick.
One thing that I think Ryan Fitzpatrick doesn't get enough credit for is his toughness. This is a guy who plays through injuries, but it's also being mentally tough. Knowing that everyone's always trying to move him out of the lineup, trying to find a replacement for him, yet he continues to battle and has earned the total respect of his teammates.
On first and 10, Fitzpatrick. Wide open, it's Marshall complete. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. And this is certainly not what you want to see in the final week of the year. We'll be back. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10.
Hey, ready, ready.
Here's Matt Forte with his first carry. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7. A look at the starting side for the offense and Brandon Marshall.
I think the thing that impresses me most about Brandon Marshall is his strength. How he runs his routes, how he wins against defensive backs downfield, how it's so tough to keep him from getting the football.
Again, they run. Again, it's Forte. And he'll take this one across the 45 up to about the 46-yard line. And still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down. And we take a look at the Bills' defense.
Whenever we talk about Zach Brown, the first thing that comes to mind is speed. He can absolutely fly at the linebacker position.
Let's see if they can convert here on third and 3.
Hey!
To throw is Fitzpatrick. And able to find Decker. They get 9 yards there and they get a first down.
I don't care how many times we say it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
It's really simple to say that they know their identity, that they are a passing team. But one of the reasons that they're so successful They know how to mix in the run and make sure that they keep the defense off balance and not able to just simply say, let's go get the quarterback and disrupt things.
On second down, Forte. And he is going to lose yardage here. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down. They tried to run the counter, just that the defense wasn't fooled.
And when they're not fooled, you see the end result. Because what you're doing there, you mentioned the counter. You're using your offensive linemen sometimes to pull or move to influence the defensive front to go in that direction and create the space back in the other side and block it appropriately. But you're exactly right. Didn't move him. Sat there waiting for him and made the play.
And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41.
One hallmark of good defenses. It's understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. And now Nick Folk, his career long, 56 yards. So this will be spotted on the midfield logo. It's a 58-yard attempt. Online, but off the crossbar, no good. A long-range effort denied 3 points at the very end. All things considered, a pretty good kick. Just cruel punishment there to be denied by the crossbar.
If you're going to hit from that distance, sometimes you're going to need a little luck. And unfortunately for him, this time the break goes against him.
First carry for LeSean McCoy, and he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up second down.
When the defensive line controls the offensive front the way we just saw there and doesn't allow any of the offensive linemen to leak downfield and get to the linebackers and block them on the second level, you end up with the type of play we just saw. Linebackers didn't have to fight anyone off, didn't have to knock anyone to the side, didn't have to elude anyone trying to block them. They just saw the play, ran to the ball, and finished things off.
Let's go! Grand 38, Ohio! Ohio!
On second down, it's McCoy. And no room to maneuver there. Give him a yard up to the 47. Couple of jets there in on the stop.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
So they run it on second down. Now let's see what third down brings here for the offense. Taylor going deep here for Watkins, and he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
So on fourth down, the Bills call on the punt unit and Colton Schmidt. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. And that one hits at the 7 but bounds into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. The Jets offense now works their way back onto the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah, get a little closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
They go play action here on first down. And that's complete to Marshall on the crossing route. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. So the offense has it first and 10.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend. I like that one, partner. They go back-to-back with excellent gains. And really, it shouldn't be a surprise who they were throwing the ball to. He's their best guy.
Yeah, we knew that they would get him involved early. They're doubling down on getting him involved early.
Don't be surprised if they'll come right back to him again. They haven't shown the propensity to be able to stop him.
They come up in an offset eye. The first down throw for Fitzpatrick. Finding time. And that's complete to Luke Wilson. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line.
And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense at every position. The tight ends have created so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time.
Fitzpatrick now to throw on first down. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Throwing again here, Fitzpatrick on second and 10. Right side, there's Decker. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
They'll try and get it with Forte. And he is going to lose yardage here. He lost 2, and it brings up 4th.
While we know that the identity of this offense is to throw the ball, they've got to run it every so often, if for no other reason than to tamp down the pass rush. They can't let them just tee off and get to their quarterback.
On now is Nick Folk in the field goal unit for the Jets. This from 42 yards out. And Folk's kick is good. And the Jets hit the board first. It's 3-0. Well, he got an early chance to redeem himself, and he's able to put that one through.
And he'll be happy he got a second chance so quickly after missing the first one. Now he's got the confidence back up before we even finish the first quarter.
After the made field goal, back out is Nick Folk to kick this one off. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And now we get our first look at a guy who's been around the block a time or two. He will not be rattled today.
And that changes things for a defensive coordinator, because normally when you get the young guys, you get the rookies, you throw all the exotic blitzes at them and looks they haven't seen. But this guy, he's seen it all.
They'll start on the ground with McCoy. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6. All right, let's take a look at the offensive starters. And the second round pick out of USC, one to talk about, Robert Woods.
I think a lot of people thought maybe he was ticketed for stardom coming out of USC. Has always been a great route runner, much more of a complimentary receiver. But they could utilize that in a big way and have him open up things in the middle.
Here we go! Let's go, Ohio! Ohio!
They'll go again to McCoy. And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other 3 here on third down? And the defense for New York.
Muhammad Wilkerson is one of the most versatile defensive linemen in the league. You can play him at any spot and expect big-time production.
And 3 full yards here for the offense to get on third down.
Ohio! Let's go! Ohio! Ohio! Ohio.
Taylor now to throw on third down. And got a man. It's Woods. And he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield.
And fits the exact right word. Over the middle, there's almost always traffic, so anytime you're a receiver in that area, you're not just focused on catching the football. You're wondering where the collision's going to come from, right? Because there's almost always someone there able to concentrate, catch it, and even add it a little extra at the end with a short run.
Let's go! One, nine,
ahead. Now Taylor on first down. He'll set up the screen to McCoy. Fighting him off.
Just ran right through the trash.
And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds.
Holding offense.
So a little grabbing there, but this time it goes against the offense for holding. They'll come out in the pistol.
Let's go! Flex round 38! Round 38! Here we go! Ohio. Ohio.
Again, we'll see the pistol here. Now it's Taylor. Right side complete. That's Woods. A gain of 6 there on first. So just a lone field goal in this first quarter of play. It's a 3-point game here early, and we will return to MetLife Stadium after this.
The NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Head & Shoulders. Shoulders were made for greatness, not dandruff.
With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Second quarter about to get underway with the Bills in possession. But they face a second and long to start things out. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield after a gain of about 4. The linebacker, David Harris, on the stop.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
They come out with one back and 3 tight ends. On third down, Taylor. And he's got his man. It's the tight end Clay. And they'll get 14 yards out of it and a fresh set of downs.
And the game just keeps evolving. Big guys running those corner routes, so difficult to cover.
One man in the backfield, that's McCoy. On first down, it's Taylor. And that's caught left side, it's Woods. Just a yard on the catch there, it'll be 2nd and 9.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive.
Flex round! Flex round! Ohio! Ohio! Let's go! Brad 38! Brad 38!
Woods the receiver in motion left. They go back to the ground with McCoy. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a 4-yard pickup there, and it leaves him with 3rd and 5.
Well, so far, this game has gone the way the defensive coordinator had hoped. They've dictated things, and they've not let them run the ball very well at all. They gave up a nice game there. I doubt it'll back off their confidence. They've played so well throughout this entire game.
And on third and five, this will be the eighth play of the drive.
Here we go. One, nine.
From the gun, it's Taylor. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And incomplete. He can't hang on. Would have been a nice catch. Instead, it brings up a fourth down.
When teams take shots at the end zone, you've got to defend it the same way you would defend the first down sticks. You defend the goal line exactly the same way. They can't cross that. You play through the receivers, and on that play, that's exactly what they did and batted it away.
Dan Carpenter now for the Bills field goal. This is a 49-yard attempt, right hand. And this one is right down the middle. And the Bills are going to tie the game at three. A little bit of a lower trajectory there on the deep kick, and it worked.
Had to do it because he had to drive it out low because of the length of the kick. Able to do that, got it above the defense and over the post.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Jets offensive unit ready to get going here. And last time able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. The drive begins with a run by Forte. And not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. A couple of Bills team up to bring him down there.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
They come up in an offset eye. They stay on the ground. Forte again. And he's got Rome. A very solid gain of 27.
That's why defense coordinators always preach 11 guys to the ball. Because sometimes you have a missed tackle, but if you have a swarm of guys around, less room for them to roam even after the first missed tackle. In this case, tackle was missed, plenty of open field to get after that.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Fitzpatrick on first down. He's got Wilson, middle of the field. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you get much more balance than this. Big-time run, big-time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group.
Hey, move 45.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Now that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Yeah, the defense definitely showing blitz here. Fitzpatrick now on second down. And this is caught on the sideline. But no, they'll say out of bounds. He caught it, but was not in bounds. Incomplete.
That was a nice catch, but unable to stay in bounds. And remember, it wasn't a wide receiver who works on that all the time.
I was going to say, he likes to get the ball handed to him. Now, don't get me wrong. He's part of the passing game as well, but maybe a little out of his comfort zone there.
Yeah, he might want to have a few words to say to us about that later, but I am still going with you on that one. Wide receivers work on a little bit more.
Incomplete pass on second down. Let's see what the offense draws up here on third. From the shotgun, it's Fitzpatrick. And that is incomplete. The tight end, Luke Wilson, was the target. And that'll bring up a fourth down.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they run successful.
On now is Nick Folk in the field goal unit for the Jets. From the right hash, this from 45 yards away. And his kick is good. Didn't hit it all that well, but he got enough on it to put it through. And they will take the lead here in this battle of field goals at 6-3. So we're trading field goals here in the opening half. No breakthrough yet on the touchdown front. We've got a 6-3 game.
And really, I like what I've seen from both of these defenses thus far. Both have been a little more aggressive than I expected. And I think that's reflected in what we see on the scoreboard, which is no touchdowns to this point.
This will be taken about the 12. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. Here's the Buffalo offense now as they get set to take over here. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
They'll start the drive with a carry by McCoy. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Tackle made by Bruce Carter. So nothing there, but maybe you blame that on the blocking.
Yeah, at some point, you've got to win at the point of attack. And on that play, that was all the defense. They made it happen.
Flex round! Flex round! Come on, let's go!
On second down, Taylor. And he's got his receiver. That's Sammy Watkins. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
Another pistol look here. Now a play fake here on first down. And lucky to get away with one there. That one nearly picked. Second down. Second down here after the incomplete pass. From the shotgun, it's Taylor. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
Whenever I see an in route dropped, as we just saw in that play, I'm always thinking that in the back of their mind, they're worried about what's coming at them because they're going towards traffic on that route as opposed to being away from it and maybe having a little bit more space.
On third down, Taylor. Looking for his tight end, Clay, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Marcus Gilchrist. And to the 40-yard line, that's where the return stops.
That was a really nice interception. I think it illustrates the differences between playing man and playing zone. When you're in man, all you're focused on is the receiver in front of you. But when you're in zone, you're allowed to read the quarterback's eyes and go to the ball. That's exactly what happened on that play.
And New York set to take the field. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had a field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get three, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Let's just go ahead and go back through that play with his eyes, because he's got to read his keys. Run or pass right off the top. You're probably going to read an offensive lineman to see if he sets up in pass protection, if he fires out for a running play. The next thing is you're going to check and see what the back's going to do, and if he ends up with the football, okay, now you got to check and see. Does an offensive lineman come downfield and try and block you? Are you going to try to elude him? Are you going to take him on and hold your spot? What are you going to do? In this case, didn't have to do any of that. Saw all of his keys, saw the play in front of him, and ran clean to the ball carrier and finished off the play. Coaches really don't care from what position they get this, but run after the catch ability, rack ability, is often the difference between winning and losing and changing field position.
So here we go, first and 10 now. They come up in an offset eye. On first down, this is Forte. He finds some open field here. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6.
We can talk about bend but don't break all we want, but the defense now, we're going to find out just how flexible and pliable they really are. Can they bounce back after that type of a run, that type of momentum against them, and find a way to slow down this offense?
2 minutes to go here in the first half. We'll come back to MetLife Stadium after this short timeout. Reminder that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll check in with Larry Ridley in Orlando with highlights and analysis of this first half of play.
And I'm going to check in with a heater.
I'm going to be right there with you, partner. 5 receivers in the game, 4 of them to the left side. Working out of the gun, Fitzpatrick. And this will be caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Jets. Quincy Anunua. His second touchdown on the season. And the Jets find a way to stretch their lead.
I wonder if he changed anything on his play sheet or they just executed better. Because they had 2 previous drives that ended in field goals before this one they finally were able to put into the end zone.
Well, whatever he did, speaking of the offensive coordinator, might be using that formula going forward. It worked there.
Yeah, it worked very well. He and his field general in pretty good sync right now. They're starting to move the ball well.
Nick Folk for the point after. And it's up and good to make the score 13-3. So that drive, 4 plays, and it ends with a Jet touchdown. Folk now set to boot it after his guys put 6 on the board. This will be taken about the 12. Oh, nice move. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. And now out come the Bills. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
They go back to the air here after the INT. This is complete to Watkins on the slant. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. Quick pass play there on the slant, Charles. Works out well for the offense.
The offense loves it. The defender hates it. Hard to get through the body of the receiver to get to the football trying to cover a slant.
Let's go! Brad 38!
Brad. On second down, here's Taylor. Looking right side, and that's complete to Watkins. A big play that time on the catch and run. And the Bills will move the chains.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
Fresh set of downs here. They'll put 2 receivers left, 2 to the right. They'll throw on first down with Taylor. And almost intercepted. It would have been his 2nd pick of the game. Instead, it'll be 2nd down. Well, he just threw an interception last drive, nearly another pick.
And things aren't very even right now, are they? It's a little bit sloppy out there, isn't it? It's kind of different driving on those paved roads and those country roads that have those potholes in them, isn't it? Because that's the way this game's going right now. A lot of bouncity bounce to it.
You spent some time on some Tennessee country roads.
I certainly have. Plenty of family back there. God love them.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
Come on,
they'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get it down inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. Give him 4 on the ground there. They're now left with 3rd and 6.
No, that wasn't an explosive run. That wasn't one that took it all the way to the house. But, boy, for a team that's had trouble running it the entire game, that's the kind of run they need, hopefully, to get themselves kick-started.
The Jets will bring in a nickel set as they try to stop this 3rd down. Taylor. And this is caught by Watkins. And he's going to have a 1st down here as he gets this one to the 17-yard line. Well, we saw the practice film this week. They wanted to focus on these intermediate passing plays, and it paid off there.
And they took that focus not just to the practice field, but in the film room to show the guys exactly what they wanted, what types of looks they should expect to get, and how they would beat those coverages each and every time. And it paid off on that play.
And he is into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Charles Clay, his 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Bills draw a bit closer.
I think everyone in the league talks about finishing, don't they? Doesn't matter whether it's a quarter, a half, a game, a series, whatever. But they're finishing the 1st half in fine style, putting that one in the end zone.
They did, and they didn't leave much time on the clock either. Well done. Dan Carpenter now for the extra point. And he puts it through. They're within 3. It's 13-10. A drive that time of 6 plays. And it ends in a Buffalo touchdown. After the TD, here's Carpenter on to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And now we get a look at the captain of this offense heading back out there now. He's played a pretty clean 1st half, a touchdown, no interceptions.
frankly, that's what they expect out of him. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game finishes. But right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, maybe looking for touchdown pass number two here in the second quarter. They start on the ground with Forte and able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
And some options here for the offense on second and two. So we have come upon halftime here in week 17 as we send you down to Orlando where we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Larry.
Thanks, Brandon. Thanks, Charles. And welcome to our EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. Both teams have arguably played well enough to be leading at this point, but you see the score and realize this one may very well come down to the wire. All right, let's do it. Here's a look at the first half highlights. Third down at the 49. Taylor is under pressure and will throw the pick. Gilchrist is in position and he is the one who comes away with the ball. After the pick, offense comes out now. Fitzpatrick's on target here, and this will go all the way for a touchdown, pushing the lead to 10. Bills have it at the 17. Taylor's got the completion out of the gun, and this play will go for 6, now trailing by just 3. So that'll do it for us here in Orlando. For the call of the second half, let's hand it back over to Brandon and Charles. Brandon.
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And now we spotlight the Jets defense. They had a pretty solid first half. Not many adjustments, but I guess there's probably always some adjustments that can be made.
Usually it's just tighten down on the things we've worked on all week in practice. Everyone thinks adjustments are bringing in something absolutely new. For the most part, it's tweaks or just emphasizing what you've worked on already. And that's what they're planning to do here in the second half.
They won't be looking to reinvent the wheel. They start the second half with a carry by McCoy. Cutback, left sideline. And he's able to get this one up to the 45-yard line.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
They come up in an offset eye. And they'll keep on the ground with McCoy. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 11 yards on the pickup, and it'll be a Buffalo first down.
Oh, he's got it going early in this one. That's the Shady McCoy. That's vintage right there, right? Breaking tackles, creating explosive runs. And if they don't take care of this early, look out. This guy's got a big, big day.
You know where he got that nickname, Shady, by the way?
I know you're going to educate me on it. Help me out.
Mama. Mama gave him that name when he was a youngster.
And if Mama named him Shady, we're going to call him Shady.
Absolutely.
Ohio! Ohio!
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. One man in the backfield. That's McCoy. Now a play fake here on first down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Let's round. Here we go. Brad 38.
Now Taylor going to hand this one off to McCoy. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third. And the offense there, the O-line, everybody really on offense, they were just manhandled at the point of attack.
Yeah, you could pretty much call them all out, couldn't you? And almost by name, right? That was a very tough sequence for the offensive line. But how about that defensive front creating a new line of scrimmage and creating a lost yardage possibility?
The gun on third down, it's Taylor. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
That was a classic example of trying to run with the ball without securing the catch. He was thinking about those rack yards instead of making the catch first and then taking off.
Here's Colton Schmidt now, on for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. And this will pin him back deep. That's going to kick out of bounds right at about the 7-yard line. Take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Hey, how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. On first and 10, Fitzpatrick. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it, no one got it. Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. But they're definitely showing blitz here. Fitzpatrick. Over the middle, and it's caught. Brandon Marshall. And he gets it up to the 10-yard line here. Now, hang on a moment here. Marshall's in some pain. Still down. And this is certainly not what you want to see in the final week of the year. We'll be back. Seven yards remaining here on third down.
Under, 45. 3-3-3-3.
Working out of the gun, Fitzpatrick. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Oh, man, for him to be that wide open and drop it. Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. Here's Lachlan Edwards now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. Fielded just inside the 20. Look at the dance and the juke. A great return there. Bobbing and weaving his way for 31 yards. And the Bills will take over the football with a first and 10. Now the Bills offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, You've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They'll try and get the running game going with McCoy. And good penetration here. He'll get this down only to about the 49-yard line. Couple of jets there in on the stop. And he's back here in the struggle department in this one like he was a week ago. And, partner, I think you can pin some of this on that O-line. The room to run, just not there.
You mentioned last week that it felt like the offensive line was getting beaten to the punch by the guys across the ball.
Well, it was pretty evident, I thought.
I mean, they were off the ball fast, penetrating, getting into the offensive backfield. Really spilling a lot of runs before they got started. So I thought your observation was spot on then, and you're right there again this week. Same thing is happening, not able to get started.
Taylor hit, he lost the football.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback, the ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Nearly lost the football, but kept it after the fumble. But now they face a third down. Watkins alone on the left side. On third down, Taylor. Looking for his tight end, Clay, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the great one, Darrell Revis. And he's just across midfield and down at the 49-yard line. And, Charles, there is a reason that they say Revis Island is in the vicinity of this guy. That's why.
It's obviously where receivers run routes, but none of them very successfully. And right now, there's another head coach asking his offensive coordinator, when are we going to learn? Don't throw it to that guy.
Here's Matt Forte as he gets set to go and heads back out there. And we have seen a decline in the numbers. Where does the fault lie? Just him? Maybe the guys up front? Combination?
Well, as you and I both know, it's almost always a collective deal. But in this case, I think maybe the offensive line got a little overconfident. They had blocked so well in the first half, picked up on what the defense was doing. I think we've seen an adjustment now that they have not picked up on, and now they're being a little bit overwhelmed.
Following the interception here, Fitzpatrick. Catch made right side by Wilson. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Give him 16 on the pickup, and it's good for a New York first down.
Almost not fair. The big guy running the corner route, being able to lean and push and get to where he wants.
So how do you stop him?
A lot of times you want to have a linebacker on him, a bigger body guy who can handle him physically. But a lot of times that doesn't work as well because his quickness often wins the route.
And the offense lining up first and 10. Forte, the lone running back. He'll get the football here. And he'll get this down to about the 30, 31-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Fitzpatrick with a give to Forte. Officially no gain on the play, and they're left with a 3rd and 8. So nothing there. I don't know that that's all in the back, though. You got to look at blocking there, don't you?
I would agree with that totally. At some point, they have to win at the point of attack. Instead, it was the defense getting it done again and holding them to no gain.
They got to get to the 23 here on third. Now Fitzpatrick. He's got time. And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
And now Nick Folk, his career long, 56 yards. This will be from 56 yards out. That's on target, but it's no good. He had it online, but it came up just shy of the crossbar. And this score will stay right where it is. So another long try for three and another kick that comes up lacking.
Yeah, this isn't going to do any wonders for his field goal percentage. But you have to figure as a head coach that when you send a guy out there to try and kick from that distance, it's a 50-50 proposition at best.
The Bills getting set to go. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. Now a first down carry here for McCoy. And he takes it across midfield to the 45. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
Really tough drive, but that run helped salvage something there because now there's something positive that came out of it. They got to see good blocking, good push by the offensive line, wide receivers trying to get involved, a good run by the back. And now maybe it'll be a catalyst for them to look at going forward, watching it on tape. Maybe they can keep incorporating that type of a run into their offense. I think that's a big pickup for a first down because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Here's Taylor to throw. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Second down now after the incompletion. From the shotgun, it's Taylor. Over the middle and caught by the tight end, Clay. And they'll get nine there as that sets him up better for third down.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do? You got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end. Take some easier completions.
The interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. One man on the backfield, that's McCoy. On third and one, it's Taylor. This is caught, Watkins. And he picks up the first as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line.
Well, we're used to seeing the guy that you consider the number one receiver double covered, but how about this guy? He's double covered and finds a way to make the play for a first down.
That's how you increase your Madden rating, right?
No doubt about that at all. And you know something? I think we'll hear about that from him soon.
Red zone opportunity.
Flex route! Flex route! Here we go! Grand 38! Grand 38!
First down and goal to go from the 7. Now McCoy. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. A good pickup there, 7 yards, and it's going to be second and goal now.
And, Brad, they went to a nickel defense, and that's a surprise this close to the goal line because ordinarily you use the back end of the end zone, the sidelines, as extra defenders, and you want bigger people on the field to try and help against the run.
Come on, let's go!
Now Taylor to throw on second down, and that's incomplete. Robert Woods, the intended receiver that time, and it's third down.
All defenders get tired of hearing about their lack of hands and why they're playing defense instead of offense. But in this situation, it was the hands that made the play. Batting the ball away on an attempted touchdown pass, excellent job, way to knock it down.
Ohio! Ohio!
third and goal, Taylor. And he is going to go down. Back at the 11-yard line, Muhammad Wilkerson in there to get him. And that's sack number 6 for him on the year. So they dial up the blitz on third and inches. It pays off.
And frankly, they were probably dialing up a run blitz, expecting him to run it in that situation. But instead, they end up back at the quarterback and put him on the ground.
So 3 points is the outcome, but probably not what they're looking for given the drive that they were on.
Yeah, things were looking good. You had it first and goal, but then the offense sputters a bit, and they're forced to settle for a field goal.
This will be taken short. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. And New York set to take the field. And last time out, another missed field goal, so maybe their confidence wavering a little bit right now in the kicking game.
And I'm with you on that. I think at this stage, they'd love to not run him back out there in a tough situation. But let's face it, they may have to. So right now, the head coach is talking to the offense coordinator and saying, call this game like we're going to put it in the end zone. Let's try and take the field goal out of it.
First and 10, Fitzpatrick. And that's off the mark, incomplete.
Normally, he's pretty reliable. Usually catches what's thrown to him. On that play, he simply dropped it.
Second down, Fitzpatrick again. Drops it underneath to Forte. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. Let's see what they go to here on third down at 6. One quarter remains here as the regular season starts to wind down. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Back now here on EA Sports. 13 all our score as we start quarter number 4.
DB on the field for the Bills here on third down.
Yeah, maybe thinking pass. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. On third down, Fitzpatrick. And he's got a new one. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
And now a first down following that long gain.
Move 45! Move 45!
They'll run it now out of the gun. So quick on the spin.
He's spinning, man.
8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Now a toss. This is Forte. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
I thought guys that were over 30 weren't supposed to run the football this well in the National Football League. How about that veteran leadership? A big-time run combined with some nice blocking by his offensive line, showing that the ins and outs of being a veteran still has his place in this league. His odometer is not totally turned over yet.
From the red zone now, Fitzpatrick. Looking for someone to throw to. Smith catches left side. Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be 2nd and 9.
Can you do any more work or make it more dramatic for not much gain than what we just saw there? Did you see how his toes got down? Tip-tap, tip-tap, got him down. But what did he get out of it?
He sold the sizzle. He just had no steak.
I mean, was it 1 yard?
Yeah, you plays like that, you at least expect a first down. They're just 1 yard. Shift together here from the D-line. Second down, Fitzpatrick. This will be caught at about the 6. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
He decided to run a hitch route. It really helped to have a guy who can turn it loose. And, boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
Seventh play of the drive now as they come up on a 3rd and 3. And some extras coming up on the line here, readying for the blitz. 3rd and short yardage, Fitzpatrick. That's caught at the 2. He didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the first down as he's tackled at the 1. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defense side of the ball right now, but you make your own defense happy. They're able to get a little more rest over on the sidelines while this one continues downfield.
A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's 2nd down.
Did your high school have that same push them back cheer?
I was a kicker.
Well, it was certainly worked. Didn't matter if we were kickers or not. That one worked, didn't it? They pushed him back at the last snap of the ball, and boy, they created a nice play for themselves. Would they lose 3 on that one?
Yeah, from the 1 back to the 4. Here's Fitzpatrick surveying the field. That's caught at the 1. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's 3rd down.
But there wasn't much there with that hitch route. They didn't gain what they expected. But sometimes when you call a hitch, you really don't have an alternate to go to. You don't have a second route to throw it to. So sometimes you have to rifle in there and hope for the best.
Now they've gotten it to the 1. Can they get that final yard here on 3rd and goal? They come out here in the eye. On the ground, Forte. And this one will wind up with him losing yardage. Back to the 4-yard line. And a loss of 3 to bring up 4.
Now that was a big stop on 3rd down. And this is where head coaches make their money and answer the question right here and now. Do you kick the field goal for the 3 points? Or do you go ahead and try and grab yourself a touchdown lead?
So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. This to break our 4th quarter tie. And Fultz's kick is good. And with that, they will move out in front by 3. So the drive here ends with a field goal, and that does give them the lead, but this one is still a long ways from over.
And you love to be able to look up at the scoreboard and see that you're out in front, but then you take one look across the field and see that offense is raring to come back out, and you think, I don't know, the field goals are going to be enough to get us home.
After the main field goal back out is Nick Folk to kick this one off. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. The Bills' offense now, they get set to head back on the field. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points?
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that'll help him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that. Super tall.
No gain there on the completion. 2nd and 10.
Ohio! Ohio! Here we go! Black Brown! Black Brown!
On 2nd down, here's Taylor. Looking right side, and that's complete to Watkins.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue. So after being silenced a week ago, he's now being silenced here in this one, and you knew a guy like him wouldn't be held down for two straight weeks.
Feels like they just decided to game plan early to get him involved and get him off the schneid, because you don't want a week like last week to linger. Just give the ball to him early and let him turn in a big-time performance, and that's exactly what he's doing.
On first and 10, it's Taylor. Left side here, caught by Clay. That throw good for four. It's second down.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
Second down now after the pass completion. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. Taylor will throw again. He'll set up the screen to McCoy. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. Call it a three-yard gain. And just like that, it's third down.
The screen was executed and completed, but where's the worry on the play? How many times is a quarterback going to get hit? Because offensive linemen have to do an acting job of making sure it looks like they're whiffing on blocks. But you got to slow them down a little bit, because if you don't, that's a lot of big guys coming at your quarterback in a big, fast way. And boy, he can get hurt.
Third down now following the completed pass. Watkins alone on the left side. Throwing again, it's Taylor. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Well, any caused incompletion is good for a defense. But when you add to it, you get a little hit on the quarterback, knock him to the ground, make him think a little bit, hopefully knock him off his game, especially in a game of this magnitude, this tight in the fourth quarter. Gotta feel pretty good as a defense.
One score down, here we go. They're gonna go for it here on fourth down. Here we go, it's Taylor on fourth down. Out to the flat, that's complete to his running back. And he's got enough for the first across midfield to the 48. Boy, that's some kind of effort. When he caught it, I doubted if he could get there. Knew it was going to be close, but credit him, really good effort.
How about the rack on that play, the run after catch? But most of the time we think of it as just being an open field and picking up yardage. Sometimes you have to be real physical in order to gain the yardage you need for a first down.
We got a man over the middle. It's Woods.
What terrifies defenses when they see slant routes thrown is that the receiver is on the move, and oftentimes he catches it and gets upfield. Does a really nice job rallying to him and stopping him for a minimal gain.
Let's go!
To throw again is Taylor. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. It'll go as a gain of six that time, and it moves the chains as well. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. So it's Bills football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. So the offense has it first and 10.
Here we go. One, nine, five.
Again, it's Taylor. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
Now that was well defended, and as a cornerback, what you're taught when you see a wide receiver screen, either you get underneath the play before the blocking forms, or you're going to have to fight your way through it by getting through some blocking. That was a really nice play there.
He'll look to throw. And his throw here is incomplete. Chris Gregg is tied in, was the intended target. And that'll make it third down. Ooh, long drive. The defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field. So now at third and 12 with an extra defender here in the secondary, a nickel look. Back to throw. taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Well, they went with the nickel. They throw in an extra defensive back. Coverage was very good.
Yeah, it was exactly as you would expect. A passing down, you bring in the nickel package. Just as you described, the coverage was excellent and allowed one of their linemen to end up getting to the quarterback.
Back to throw. Hit as he throws, and this is going to be incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and that's going to be just about all she wrote for this one. Here comes the field general leading his offense back out there for the next possession. So, Charles, there are the numbers. What's happened here? Defensive adjustments that's caused him to sort of fall off a bit?
I think so. That has to happen. You've got to make some changes because in the first half, they were pretty effective. But the second part is sometimes when you're doing really well, you get off your game a little bit. You get off the gas a little. You're like, okay, we've got this thing. And that's not necessarily the case. Maybe right now, someone just needs to tell a joke in the huddle, loosen things up, and get their big guy going again.
Here comes the D swarming to the line. They come out here in the eye. On the counter, Forte. And once again, not much running room, if any at all. And now the Bills are going to stop it as they call a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages.
Hey, move 45. Move 45.
Now a run. This is Bilal Powell. And he'll be brought down at... Now the Bills will take another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Here's Lachlan Edwards now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. Now a high kick, almost a pooch punt. And he did get it back, I do think. Yes, so no turnover on the punt, and it'll be a first down.
I know there's no magnet in the ball, but sometimes for the punt returner, after such a scramble, it sort of feels that way, doesn't it? He has it, he loses it, somehow ball finds his way back to him.
A tone for his sin, and you know he's taking a deep sigh of relief right now. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And he can't hang on to it. That would have sealed it. Instead, second down.
I know that interception was dropped, and it would have been their third of the game. And I will guarantee you, in the huddle, on the bench, all the defensive guys have been talking about is, we've got this guy right where we want him. Who's going to get the next one? It almost becomes a challenge, and they've missed a golden opportunity.
He's going to let it fly. And it's incomplete. So their final drive comes up empty. And with that, the ball game is over. Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play. We're still... You're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.
So for the Jets, it will wind up a 500 season as the win means they'll finish right at 8-8. And they'll be able to enjoy this one through the bye week before they get back at it again. Meanwhile, for Buffalo, they're going to bottom out here to wrap up this very forgettable season at 2-14. And they'll get the extra week to think about this one as they return to action in 2 weeks' time. So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. It's a win for the Jets as we say so long from MetLife Stadium.